So there are a wide variety of project management software out there, and it's normally quite difficult if you're a team to pick the right one because there doesn't seem to be many variances between all of them. So in this video, we're going to help you pick the best project management software that we believe will help you to excel with your team and scale as you can imagine. All of the tools that are listed in this video will be linked below, as well as in-depth guides on all of them to help you really dig a little bit deeper, because that research part of this is so fundamental. Whether you've been assigned the job of going to find project management software in your team, or whether you're looking for yourself to get a head start, this is going to be really important, that research phase. So if you're new here, welcome, do subscribe and check out Tool Finder if you're in the hunt for any productivity tools, that'll be listed below. So as you can imagine, there are a wide range of tools, and the first one on our list is called Monday.com. Now, for those who don't know, Monday.com is probably one of the longest standing productivity applications for project management, and it has been in the market for some time. Now, as you can imagine, what it does quite well is it's quite a flexible tool, but what they've done recently is begin splitting their product out a little bit more. So in this video, I'm referencing something called Monday.com Work Management, but there's also two other versions of Monday.com now, and it seems to be growing. The other one's called Dev, and the other one's called Sales CRM, and they're more specific experiences for developers and for those who work in sales and maybe marketing who want to capture the CRM process and system. And they're essentially really fine-tuned solutions for Monday.com, but this version is much more open plan in terms of getting you started with all the features to get you moving in terms of general project management. So Monday.com work management system is really like many other project management systems. It's got a wide range of views that are really flexible and a bunch of templates to get you started. It really is, I guess, a more generalized project management system, and you may have seen the ads maybe even before this video, because it's widely popular in terms of their marketing and their efforts. Well, largely the application has expanded much more since I last checked it out, with automations and integrations being part of the experience, allowing you to save time doing small things that you do typically every day on Monday with automations and a bunch of integrations. Over 200 apps and integrations live on their marketplace, which means you can connect it with a wide range of apps, and it's seemingly like they're growing this experience out even further. Largely, if you're looking at Monday.com, it's because you're looking for an all-rounder. And that's what I'd probably say, out of all this list, this is one of the most or best all-rounders for project management. So number two is Basecamp. And for those who don't know, Basecamp is developed by a company called 37 Signals. And it has been, again, on the market even much longer than Monday.com. And what I would say is it's a stellar application if you work remotely and asynchronously as a team. And the reason why I recommend it is because it really does endorse those more asynchronous communication aspects, like leaving threads for people to follow up on in their time, and it promotes states of deep work. So it doesn't necessarily always have you real-time communication, a bit like Slack or some of the other list options in these ones, because what it does is it wants you to be a little bit more respectful of other people's time. This works really well for remote teams, even hybrid teams, that want to be able to communicate in a slower fashion, but in a much more robust fashion, so that employees can have that focus time on actual work with less meetings. So Basecamp has a bunch of features that are very impressive. They've got, for example, campfire, so you can have that real-time communication, message boards, to-do list, schedules, and it also helps you to organize your own schedule ahead. And it has some project management elements, maybe not as much as some of the other options on this list, but largely there are abilities to manage things like card tables, and also some newer abilities that allow you to manage and triage, but also see a timeline of your projects coming up. So Basecamp's quite an expansive tool, but I would probably recommend it as the best one for async and remote teams out there. Again, it's a very, they have their own theories and concepts inside this application, so it's important that you align with them before you dive in. So the third option on our list is really popular with marketing and sales in particular, and it's called Ryke. Now, Ryke is, it's not going to look as snazzy, in my opinion, as Monday.com and Basecamp, but it does look and work functionally well. It's actually owned by a much bigger company now, who purchased it for over $2 billion a couple of years ago, and that company is called Citrix Systems. Now, largely, this application is really popular with marketing and sales teams, because those who may work in creative agencies or client-facing teams, what they can do with Ryke is essentially organize all their work, but even be a lot closer to the image proofing and feedback process that typically goes on with those client-based activities. So if you have something like an image that you want to prove for social media, you can post it in the comments and actually get real granular detail breakdown on what the issues that you need to fix in on those images are. And that's not just good for images, it's good for files, and a lot of teams really, really like that for the file management aspect. And there are a bunch of typical things that you would see inside of a project management software, but one, Gantt chart is very traditional in terms of its setup and on par in terms of its function with apps like Team Gantt and Gantt Pro. So if you're somebody that wants a all-round project management tool that does have some advanced Gantt abilities, then this is going to be a neat tool for you. There's also functions inside of the more pricey options for managers that allow you to do workload management. And this is great for scheduling people's time, making sure they're not overwhelmed by the jobs they have at hand. This is great for managers. And as you can imagine, in agencies, that's perfect for time-based allocation. So I would say Ryk, again, is a great all-rounder. They also have some additional abilities like add-ons for marketing insights as well that marketing teams will really like too. So again, much more of an all-rounder, but popular with marketing and sales teams. Next up is Asana. Asana has been on the market for some time, and it was actually created by one of the Facebook co-founders. And naturally, it has been growing for over 10 years, maybe even 15 years now. And it's really popular with product teams, creative teams, and IT teams that manage operations. And that's because it's a great all-round experience in terms of what I would say is a little bit like Trello, which we have list actually next up, is it's an all-round experience, but one that you don't need as much education to get started, in my opinion. So for example, with Monday.com and ClickUp, I would say there's a little bit more education needed for these type of applications. But with Asana, it's much more approachable in terms of getting your team on board. So at the same time, you have boards and timelines, you can manage your own productivity inside of Asana, and there are a wide range of features that keep quite clutter-free for organizing your work. There's also, on the free plan to get you started, over 100 integrations to get you going, which is decent, and the workflow builder will give you loads more abilities when you upgrade to premium for your team. So it's well worth looking at if you want an all-round experience that is much more approachable and popular with those product operations and IT teams that just want something that is probably approachable and easy to get on with. Next up is Trello, and Trello has been acquired by Atlassian, which happened a fair few years ago, but at the same time, it is probably one of the best Kanban-based experiences on the market. It has some more power features recently with features like Power Up and Butler inside of the Pro account, which gives you more abilities to add things like custom fields and get the actions done with them, which is nice for setting up automations and processes. The plugin store is also quite widely available now, which means you can get a wide range of plugins that either Trello build or people externally build too. Things like Card Snooze, ReadMe, Pomerello for using Pomodoro timers, and Trello have extended beyond the Kanban experience to the likes of Timeline, Calendar View, and Table View as well, which means that they have much more opportunity in the future. I typically always recommend Trello for probably around 20 to 50 people because it's really approachable and quite easy to use, to be honest. Number six is ClickUp, and ClickUp is very similar to Monday.com. It's quite like expansive for those who want to use it, meaning there's quite a lot of flexibility and setup time. But it's one of these ones that has almost every feature you can think of inside of it. And I would say even slightly more than likes of Monday.com. When you compare the two, you look at ClickUp and it has more abilities inside of it. So for example, they have documents, whiteboards, which is a function that is separate in Monday.com called Work Canvas. It's a separate application that you can combine with Monday.com, but just slightly separate. Whereas ClickUp has whiteboards, and it also has a range of other abilities like chat, which means you can set up real-time chat in the different projects and spaces that you create, which is perfect for aligning the team on a particular type of topic. So I would say that ClickUp is great for those who are willing to set things up and going with sort of a really flexible all-round application, and they're willing to learn from it. Because I think once you learn it and adopt it, it's actually very, very powerful. ClickUp has also got a 3.0 version, which in 2023 has been launched, but it's been growing quite rapidly. And a lot of people are finding that they're wanting to replace a lot of different parts of their tech stack inside of ClickUp, which is becoming much more common in the productivity space, that's for sure. Number seven is Smart Suite. Now, this one is a fairly new one to the list, and it reminds me a lot of if sort of like ClickUp and the likes of Airtable had a baby. It's sort of a combination, and it's a records-based project management system. So, for example, you get all of the features as part of your sort of getting started experience, which is great. So you get the wide range of views that they have, including dashboards, which are typically unlockable, and you can unlock them in the more premium pricing options of some of the other apps that we've talked about, like I believe monday.com lock them under a certain pricing. So you get that, and you get a lot of other views as part of the free plan, which is good. But the pricing begins when you hit a certain record amount. So if you add like 500 records for a CRM you're building, then it's going to move over to a paid quite quickly. So it's important to be able to evaluate whether the application is better for you because you've got lots of records, or you've got less records, or you're inputting stuff. And it basically means just items that you add to the system. Now, I really liked it when I checked out Smart Suite because there's collaborative in terms of the way that you can set things up. There's loads of different solutions that you can build. That's how they sort of define how you create things inside of Smart Suite. And it's really powerful. Like, the customization is really, really good, a little bit like Airtable. And it has that slight structure like ClickUp, which a lot of people will find beneficial. There are features in this application, like, for example, guides, so that when you join a new solution, there's a guide for your team to follow it and understand what it's about. And also, I found that it was quite fast on all of the devices that I tested it on, which I wasn't sure whether would be the case because it's quite record-based, and obviously loading lots of records might mean speed is a compromise. But I was very impressed with it at the least. So Smart Suite, blend between Airtable and ClickUp. So next up is Coda. Now, Coda is a really powerful document-based project management software. And what I mean by that is it sort of looks like Google Docs on steroids. You can create a document, and inside those documents, you can add in-page templates, which you can create whatever you want. You can manage a project in there. You can connect things up between pages. So it can be anything from your roadmap to all of your sales CRM. It really is up to you. But Coda have done a really good job with AI in helping you set pages up really fast. And there's also formulas and packs, which are going to save you a bunch of time connecting popular integrations. Now, this is really very similar to the likes of Notion. It's a build your own productivity setup. But I think that it's slightly better in terms of the formula and functions than you would get on something like Notion, because I feel like the optionality and the power behind it, there is a lot more once you learn it. There's actually somebody in the productivity space called the Coda Guy who does a fantastic course called Coda School, which I will link below in. But Coda is impressive for those formula and packs. And if you're willing to give it a go and build your own setup, then I would probably recommend Coda because it is really nice and it's approachable like documents as well. So it's great for team wiki management and knowledge there too. So next up is Smart Suite. And again, a great all-round project management software. And if you follow Formula One, it is McLaren F1's sponsor, well, at least of 2023. So you may have seen it on the side of the car and be like, I've seen that somewhere. Essentially, Smartsheet wants to be a all-round project management software, sort of very similar to Wrike in a sense. It allows you to build a great structure in terms of all of the different lovely views like grid view, Gantt view, card view, calendar view. And basically, there's a few abilities when it comes to dashboards as well. There's also something called work apps, which essentially help you build custom experiences for each department. So instead of getting a software for each department, you could build one that's better suited and more scalable for those type of teams. And I think I've been reading a lot of reviews about it, a lot of people saying that this has been really helpful, saving time setting up with their team. And finally on our list is Notion. Notion has been on the market for some time and it is growing in popularity. It's also got a new Notion projects area, which allow you to set up combination of tasks, combination of projects, and weave them all in between each other. Now, Notion does have some great templates that are going to save you time in terms of building the perfect workspace for you and your team. But to be honest, it's going to take a little bit of time to get used to because it just needs some education to get started. It's not as approachable as some of the other traditional project management software tools like monday.com, which are already pre-built. There are some pre-built elements like the templates, but it's not necessarily going to educate you how to utilize all of those and how they all connect. Notion is made up of databases and also naturally pages. So you have to sort of build them, customize them to yourself a little bit more. But to be honest, the projects database and the one they hook up with tasks is actually going to save you a lot of time because it's already pretty well built, but you're going to have to customize it a little bit further if you want those detailed, granular customizations solutions for your team. So what's nice about Notion as well is they're investing a lot in the AI side of stuff. There's a feature called Q&A, which allows you, once activated, to scan the entirety of your Notion account and get answers. And a lot of people have been using Notion as a team wiki. But largely, this is very similar to Coda, to build your own productivity environment, but is also great for individuals that are looking to organize their own productivity alongside their work and have them fairly close to each other. Not a traditional project management software, but one that is growing in the market. So hopefully this was useful. If you're in the hunt for more traditional options, I would probably go with the likes of Monday.com, Sana, Rike, Trello, even ClickUp. But I would say the other options that are slightly stranger or slightly more different in this list are the likes of Basecamp, Smartsuite, Coda, and Notion. And all of these options are very interesting. But it's well worth reading all our reviews on Toolfinder to hunt down the right one for you. So hopefully we gave you the insights that you need to know about choosing your next project management software. Let us know in the comments below which one you went with. We'd love to hear. But in the meantime, if you want to dive over to any productivity tools, even your own personal productivity tools, jump over to Toolfinder. And I'll see you in a future video. Cheerio. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you enjoyed it, you can check out another video here on YouTube diving into productivity tools. But if you did want to, you can jump over to Toolfinder to discover any productivity tools, which will be linked here as well. We have a resource of over 250 productivity tools and growing. And naturally, there are reviews, insights, and much more. So do check it out below. But thank you very much for watching this video.